Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today I'm gonna be teaching you how to use 3ds Max. So this will be like this learning 3ds Max series where I'm gonna be covering the core basics of Max, and we're gonna level up, you know, to more complex stuff on creating actual scenes, rendering, etc, etc. Just a disclaimer, I'm not gonna be canceling the other RenderRam stuff, it's just that I'm gonna be doing this also, right? So in our first tutorial, we're gonna be covering the core basics on how you can instantly start doing anything in Max. So I'm gonna skip covering, you know, all the functionalities of the buttons that you see on your screen. I'm just gonna go straight to you being able to create something. So when you open up the Max, this is pretty much what you see. So massive window here, this is a viewport, or this is your actual 3D space where you're gonna be placing all your objects. And now we see tons of buttons here, tons of buttons there, there's some numbers here. We're gonna get to all of that. So let's create, let's just break the ice and create the first basic object. So if you go here to the right, you can see box, sphere, cylinder, teapot, whatever. Let's click on the teapot, for example. You click it and just anywhere in the viewport, just click with your mouse button and just hold the click and just drag, and you're going to create a teapot. Now, if you click on the sphere, for example, the same thing will happen. Click, drag, you got yourself a sphere. Cool thing is, when this sphere is selected, you can just create multiple spheres and you can just create this little cute bubbly world. But what if you want to move these things, rotate these things, etc.? So to kind of get out of the whole, you know, sphere creation thing, you can see how my mouse is like this little cross. That's pretty much because it's in this creation mode. So in Max, you just cancel everything by right click. So just right click and there we go. We cannot create anything. It's just selection. So let's click on our teapot. One thing that you can notice, whenever you hover your mouse over any object, it's gonna get this yellow outline. That pretty much means that object can be selected. But when you select the object, it's gonna get this bluish tint. So look at this. If I select this red sphere, you see how it kind of turns bluish? So let's select the teapot. To move, rotate the teapot, make it bigger or smaller, etc., we're gonna have to use some of these buttons. So when you go to the top, your main buttons to manipulate objects are these: select and move, select and rotate, or select and uniform scale. So what does that do? When you click on the select and move, you can notice that you got these little pointy arrows. And when you click any object, you can see that you always see those arrows wherever you click. So how does it work? With this, you can pretty much move your objects, right? But take a look at this. If I, for example, hover over the red arrow here, you can see it turns yellow. So now when I click and move, it's gonna move in that red direction. This is the X direction, this is the Y direction, and this is the Z. If I just click here, it's gonna move it in the Y direction. One thing that you can notice, so we are moving it, you know, forward and backward. But if I wanna move it left and right, I cannot do that, you see, because we literally locked the movement on this kind of direction. So if I want to move the teapot, you know, left and right and back and forth, what you can do, you see how this one turns yellow too, but if you go somewhere here in between, you can see both of them turning yellow, and now you can just move things around freely. If you want to rotate, it's pretty much the same thing, it's just that the icon is a little bit different. You also have, you know, like what is selected. The blue one here, if I just hover my mouse there and click, I can rotate the teapot like this. And then like if I go to the red one, now you can pour the teapot into a glass pot or whatever. Now the green one is just tilting it on its side. Now the scale button, when you click it, let's say on our teapot, if your mouse is like in the center of the whole scale, it's gonna uniformly or like equally make the teapot bigger or smaller. It works with spheres also, it's the same logic. But if you go to one of the arrows here, like this one, it's gonna stretch it out in that direction. So if I go to the Z one, it's just gonna make it taller. And this is generally the basic principle of manipulation things in Max. Now for all this manipulation to be kind of more clear, more visible, Max doesn't have just this large 3D space. It actually has four of those 3D spaces, like four of those viewports. And let me show you how you can activate those. So if you go to the most bottom right button, just go all the way down right. Wait, is it on the camera this side? Or just go to the bottom right, click on this button here. You got these four 3D viewports. Now, why are these useful? You know what? Let's actually do some modeling. So take a look at this. I'm going to just select all of these objects and hit delete button. I want to create, let's say, a table, like a basic little table. So let me click on the box and I'm just going to create like the first table leg. For me to access like the properties of that leg, we can adjust the properties here. But in general, the right way to do it is from this button here. So this is called the modify tab. Now, these are like the internal properties of the object that you selected. So you go to the length, and let's say the length, let's say to be 5, width 5, and let's say height 30. Now we got ourselves, you know, a leg of the table. Now I want to create 4 of these legs, and then I want to create, you know, the top part of the table. Now, should you always go, you know, and click the box and just create again and then create again and then create again? Well, not really, because that's a little bit time consuming. What you can do instead, you can clone this leg 4 times or 3 times extra, and you know, you're gonna get all your identical legs. So how do you approach cloning? Whenever you right click on any object, you're going to get a lot of options that, you know, can be applied to that object. And one of the options is a clone. So when you click on the clone, this little clone options is going to pop out. Just click OK. So visually nothing happened because you have duplicated the object, but it's in the same position as this one. So you pretty much do not see any difference. But look at this. If you go to your move tool here and just move it to the right, you got yourself a cloned leg. Now, let's go to this viewport because we still need 2 extra legs. So you can, from here, select both of these, right click and just click clone again, hit OK, and now under X axis, just move it here. And there you go. We got ourselves some, you know, first 4 legs of the table. Now, if I want to make the top part of the table, I'm just going to go and hit box again. And I'm just going to draw it, let's say, like this. Since we are in the creation mode, you see, like, we can now just endlessly create boxes. Just hit right click, and that's going to activate the whole gizmo thing where you can move it around. And just lift it up like this. And there you go, you got yourself a first table. Now, if you want to kind of manipulate this 3D space to kind of see more clearly where things are, there's a couple of buttons that you can click, which also have shortcuts. So for example, if you go to the bottom right here, you can see this button which says orbit sub object. Click on that and you're going to get this yellow circle. Now, when you click inside of that circle and just hold your click and start moving your mouse, you can notice how, you know, your whole viewport is spinning. Additionally, if you just hold your scroll wheel button, so this button, right? If you just hold it and drag it, you're kind of panning the whole, you know, 3D space left and right. But since Max is like turbo heavily dependent on shortcuts, you know, like it's all about shortcuts. You're just gonna automate everything in the future. So what you can do is hold Alt and hold your, you know, middle scroll wheel and just start moving like this. So look at this. I can just pan with my middle mouse button. And now when you hold Alt and middle mouse button, you can rotate like this. See, like you can orbit around your object. And congratulations, you just modeled a table. About other functionalities of Max, or the things that you see here, we got some menus on the top. So the first menu, like file menu here, you can, you know, save stuff, create new scenes or whatever. The others from edit and all the way to the right, these are like all turbo internal 3ds Max stuff. By the way, for Max, like a default undo redo shortcuts apply, like Control Z, Control Y, you know, it's, or you got these buttons here. So this is like undo, redo. So like undo things, redo things. For your first kind of Max experimenting and just clicking what things do, I think from all of these buttons, you know, move, rotate, scale, undo, redo are pretty much what you just need to start playing with the software. Another thing that you can experiment, you see like here how we created the box, sphere, cylinder, etc. There's much more objects that you can create in Max. So if you click on the standard primitives here, you're gonna get a list of all the potential objects that you can create. So for example, if I click on the extended primitives here, you have some different objects here. If you always wanna go back to your boxes and cylinders, you know, just go back to standard primitives. But yeah, let's go to extended primitives. And here, for example, we have an object that's called torus knot. So what does torus knot look like? So look at this. So if I just click and drag, I'm gonna get this. This is a torus knot. Now when I release my mouse button and just freely move it up and down, I'm actually adjusting the thickness of this object. On the other hand, if you click here and go to stairs, you have like a straight stair. So you click here, release, move there, click again, and look, you got yourself some nice stairs. So there's many things that you can do. You can create your first house or whatever you like. Just remember, anything that you do, you always want to access the extra properties of the object. So for example, if you want these stairs to kind of, you know, be different, always click here next to the little plus button, and here you're gonna see like, you know, what type of stairs they want. They want it to be an open stair, closed stair, box stair, whatever. Just play with the options. The best way to learn 3ds Max is generally just click on the random buttons on the screen and see what they do. Try to, of course, make some sense from it, but in general, just click, 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 and things are gonna start happening and you're gonna memorize it. For some buttons, nothing is gonna happen, but you know, that's all the, you know, but that's the learning experience. So since my Max is a little bit customized, so for example, you know, here where we were setting up the stair options, you can notice that I have a bunch of these buttons here. You don't have those buttons. Those are my custom made buttons. So yeah, whenever you open Max, you know, on the top, you have some basic manipulation tools. On the right, this is where you can create your object. If you click on this little icon next to the plus, you can modify your objects here. So for example, you know, if you have your table and you want, you know, the thickness of your top part of the table to be, I don't know, thinner, you can just type number 2 here and boom, it's gonna be thinner. On the other hand, on the bottom, you can see the timeline. This is like an animation timeline. So, so whenever you create an animation of like robots fighting an offensive villa or something, you can just click on the play button here and you can see the timeline is gonna start running, and that's pretty much when the animation happens. But since we haven't animated anything, nothing is happening. So you can just unclick it and that's pretty much it. So this pretty much covers, you know, what you need to do to kind of start doing anything in Max. This is what I wanted to show you. Now for your homework, I want you to experiment. I want you to click on the buttons. For a start, I want you to go to the little plus icon and just select this. And here, just experiment with all these objects and just try to see what can you create with these. You know, you have a lot of, you know, different shapes that you can experiment with. You know, just get familiar to the whole user interface. Our next video is pretty much gonna be, you know, an official start video where I'm actually going to be explaining options. We're going to be covering some wireframes, a thing called shapes, or how you can write texts in Max, you know, kind of make, I don't know, cool things, whatever, add some lights, you know, add materials. So it's going to be fun. So yeah, stick around and stick around and find out. See you in the next video. Bye.